What's going on? Hashtag Burritos Nation. It's your boy Rainbow Warrior here, messing up the beginning of the episode. So I'm trying to, you know, because it starts with super card in the episode. So I'm going to try to add this little part right here. This is WWE. Supercard, we are at 391. Hopefully in this episode we'll have some fun. We got the Terminator eye going on because I need to charge my phone, homies. Trying to find some place to go. So I guess I'm gonna have to stand right over or sit right over the kitty litter. Don't sit in the kitty litter, Rainbow. Write in the comments below. Don't sit in the kitty litter, Rainbow. Because why not? Let's see. We don't have a team for in Snow Surfer 22, but we got the grinding, always grinding, Heenan family, which is awesome like a possum. First of all, we'll go ahead and shout out people in our King of the Ring. Got myself killing it. Hopefully we kill it in the contenders bracket. I don't like to brag, so I'm not going to jinx myself right now. But I'm Rainbow or some teen. I'm rocking that SummerSlam Dolph Ziggler. That's awesome like a possum in my opinion. 42-2. We got Hammer 36-8. We got Killer Neptune, who I've been in a lot of King of the Rings with. Torito, the KJ. Ooh, it looks like maybe he just pulled a Big E or something like that, because it's been Jericho for a while now. VHL, Super Card. Ramon, Tombstone, Daniel Bryan, Nutachi, Sitambu, Daniel Bryan, Lolona, and Chuchu. So there's like six boxes in this King of the Ring, SFD, stuff like that. So we should be in about an hour and 15 minutes be going into the contenders bracket. I'm guaranteed getting that first spot. So this should be pretty cool. So hopefully we get ourselves something good. So right now, what we're doing right now, we have 201 points to go. So that means if we were 200, if it were 200 on this spot, that'd be 20 points for each person. Well, so there's basically 20 points for each person and one on one extra one for someone else. 21, which will be my birthday soon. My birthday is October 16th, if you guys forgot from last year. But let's see, we pulled the title match, so we're going to go up against the Blood Gamers, the Gamers of the Blood. We need to get ourselves... you know, we definitely got this, man. A lot of people in my chat right now, they're saying, come on, guys. It's really, really close. But in my opinion, it's not that close as long as the whole entire team grinds. I know some people are busy right now, but I definitely think we're going to be able to get this Samoa. I'm really, really hoping we are. I mean, if it gets down to the wire, I'll put some credits in. I do not spend any credits on team events like a lot of you guys know. But we shall see, yo, what's going to go on in tomorrow's episode. You guys will see if I got myself my Samoa Pro or not. All right, so let's see here. And you'll also see a King of the Ring award, which is pretty cool too. So hopefully that is another SummerSlam one. I should probably actually go back and see how many we've gotten in a row. Of course, I might jinx myself, but I know that it's been a while since we've not gone to the finals of the King of the Ring. So we're on a roll for sure. So yeah, but anyways, guys, where's your team at in your team? Road to Glory Grind. Is it blowing your mind? Like a shiny sun, being nice and kind, because it's nice when people are kind to you. Don't you guys just appreciate when people are kind to you? I do, for sure. All right, so let's see. We're throwing in Becky Lynch. It's looking like, so far, I'm not even paying attention to what I'm doing. Hopefully the score is good. We're up 5-2. So it looks like our team's still pretty OP at this point. So we are definitely still not even having to care about what cards we're throwing in as long as we have our best cards in. I'm surprised that I haven't gotten any beef for my team since I still have half-level pros. Once I get a few more better pros, I'll end up leveling a couple of, like, maybe my Braun Strowman and my Finn Balor all the way. Because right now, I don't have one fully level pro, not even event cards. All right, so there we go. Got a nice little, nice stack call. There is my AJ Styles. That's how you know. Because your boy Rainbow, of course, messed up on his AJ Styles. But it actually works out in my favor because it's actually better than my event cards. So it's really, really good. I'm thinking that once I get a few more pros, I'm actually going to do that to a couple of my other extra cards. And I might actually take my two of my event cards out of my King of the Ring so they can be specifically only Exhibition, Road to Glory, Ring Domination, and King of the Ring cards. Because, yeah, or not King of the Ring. What am I even saying? Team cards, yeah. All right, so there we go. Let's go ahead and put these guys in. I don't know why I just did that. I'm probably going to lose now. No, we're going to win that. We're going to win that because we're two pros against their one SummerSlam pro and their WrestleMania pro, Roman Fistum Reigns. All right, so there we go. If you guys want to know why I call him Fistum Reigns, I'm not going to go ahead and reply to that because I'm keeping it PG, even though I do put in some little stuffs in there. But yeah, all right, so anyways, I'm going to stop babbling about that. I'm going to go ahead and pick up a cryback, a nice little fitty credit Miz of the uncommon tier, The Rock, the great one. Let's make Darryl Young great again. We actually haven't seen him on TV for a while. they just randomly, WWE sometimes just say, hey, swag bag. They just sometimes randomly, you know, just stop doing stuff when it comes to storylines, and then they'll just like bring it back out of nowhere. So I definitely think we're going to get this card. We're going to go ahead and do a couple of more matches here. We're going to go up against HB Shizzle and all that cool for Shizzle Nizzle, because that's pretty cool. All right, and Swag Bag is actually going to be on the card at No Mercy, where I'm going to be. So I'm actually going to see one of my couple of my favorite wrestlers wrestling, because my favorites, one of my favorites is Swag Bag, even though he doesn't get a lot of wins. So I like the guy, man. I like his gimmick, the Wii. The people. Obviously, that's the wrong hand because I'm holding my phone with my right hand, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean if it makes you want to scream. Yeah, but any cool King of the Ring awards you guys have gotten, let me know in the comments below as well. And it doesn't matter any tier. You guys don't have to be SummerSlam. So I'm not racist. I'm not tierist. It doesn't matter what tier you're in. Just let me know in the comments below any cool King of the Ring worlds, any cool pulls. If you're in Legendary tier, if you got yourself a nice little Diva Pro, Legendary Pro, you got yourself a nice little Pro, anything that you guys really, really like, even if it's same thing with me. Like, Dolph Ziggler's not a good card, but I would love to get another Dolph Ziggler. Same with you guys. If Xavier Woods is your favorite card, let me know in the comments below. Have you guys gotten yourself some Xavier Woods card? That's pretty cool, too. Man, I just can't get out of that stupid thing. The brightness, it's killing me, guys. It is killing me. We're only at 17% on the phone. All right, gotta check to turn my laptop on, because I always gotta have it on so I can go ahead and do stuff with my videos after I upload them. But yes, guys, I'm very, very hyped about this Sunday going with my cousin's husband to Mercy. So that should be really, really awesome, like a possum. So yeah, shout out to Mike. That's my cousin's husband's name. That's pretty cool. And there we go, Emilicious. I'm very, very excited about this. If you guys didn't see on Raw already, I'm really hoping that, I don't know, man, what they're going to do with her gimmick, but it is confirmed that Emma is coming back to WWE soon, and it's saying the transformation from Emma to Emelina. What type of name is Emelina? I'm pretty sure I'm going to keep on calling her Emma, as well as a lot of wrestling fans. I just don't know what's going to happen there, but I am always an Emma fan. She is my favorite woman wrestler. She's not the best, but that beige, that just looks awesome. I really want to get a Paige card. I would love to have an Emma card as well. But yes, Emma's going to be always one of my favorites, and she's a really, really good wrestler. I'm just hoping that they don't just make her like an Eva Marie where it's just to show off how she looks. I mean, she's gorgeous, man. Emma is absolutely Emilicious gorgeous, but she's a great wrestler too, in my opinion, and I want to see her do actual wrestling stuff. I did like her gimmick that she was going on before she just came up to the main roster again too with this gimmick, and then she got hurt and had that back surgery, so she's finally back, and I'm just hoping that they use her correctly and not with a stupid just, oh, look at my body gimmick. I would love to see her actually get a serious run, possibly get a championship match in the future. Would be awesome, like a possum. I would love to see her as a heel as well. I don't want to see her as a face. She's just absolutely awesome as a heel. Just like a bad, bad, bad mama jamma. All right, so let's see. Let's go and do one more matchup, and then we'll go and end off the episode right here. Tell me in the comments below your thoughts about what's going on in WWE right now, about Emelina, as she's going to be called, about No Mercy coming up. What are your predictions? And all that cool stuff. I might do an episode, if you guys want, in the comments below, a predictions episode or something. Or maybe I can actually record myself, if you want, maybe in the thing. I won't do much, because I'll be focusing on how cool the new Golden One Center is in Sacramento. It is going to be the first ever live sporting event in the new Golden One Center in Sacramento. So I'm really, really hyped about that, to be making history with that, because that's pretty cool. And the first two events are actually two Paul McCartney concerts, who was at the Beatles originally. But yeah, pretty excited about it. A lot of cool stuff. And I'm just hyped. Hypey, hype, 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 hyped. Yes. I still stay with Finn Balor right here to beat up on Randy Orton. All right, Randy, no RKO out of nowhere for you today. Ooh, look at that Lita. Lita's going to destroy their Naomi. She's not cartwheeling like a homie there. Let's go ahead and put in my Finn Balor to get wrecked. Oh, man, I have the worst cards in my team. Of course, besides my Sasha. Actually, surprisingly, no one on my team yet has a SummerSlam Pro Diva. And I remember I had one really, really early. And of course, as you guys know, I had really, really good luck in WrestleMania tier with Divas. And I've yet to get a Pro yet. So I really, really hope to get to the finals in this King of the Ring again. And then maybe to get myself a Charlotte or a Sasha or even a Nia. I will take any Diva Pro any woman wrestler pro at this point, I would just absolutely love to get myself a Charlotte, just because she's the best in Supercard, as well as, in my opinion, I've told you guys this before, I don't like Charlotte because of her gimmick, but I will admit, in my opinion, Charlotte is the best women's wrestler that WWE has going on right now. She is just she's just so talented on the mic as well as in the ring. Just she does everything awesome. I just hate her gimmick, how she has to have someone with her at all times. Like last night, she lost the title to Sasha. Spoiler alert, sorry about that if you haven't seen Raw yet. But she just had an amazing show. That corkscrew moonsault backflip thing, man. I know that she was going for the moonsault again. I was like, oh, sick, she's going for the moonsault again. Then she turned it into a corkscrew as well, and it's just so amazing, man. It's just, man, I want to see more of that stuff from Charlotte. I want to see her wrestling by herself. I want her to drop Dana. I want Dana able to still be relevant on Raw, because I do like Dana Brooke, but I feel like both of them should be separate. All right, so we got a little bit of a glitchy glitch going on right here, and there we go. All right, there we go. My phone froze. Oh, yay, title match. That's pretty cool. But yeah, guys, a lot of banter, a lot of talking going on in this episode about what I'm thinking about in WWE. Let me know in the comments below something, anything you guys want to talk about in the comments about WWE. Let me know anything in your game and all that cool stuff. My phone has frozen again, and there we go. Stop in the name of love. And we'll stop this episode right there on that stop sign. But anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this episode, let me know in the comments below. Give me a like, comment, and subscribe, and stop. And I will see all of your hashtag Burritos Nation later. We don't want no ham and cheese. We just want burritos, please. Yeah.